Up next, we got Donald Trump. Like, subscribe, and let's get to this motherfucker.
Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
Fuck Donald Trump. Days ago, man, hey. If you ain't hit up CDB Entertainment, man, go hit him up, man. Mr. McIntyre, everybody, man. Got the merchandise, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate the cowboy, Chase the Bag Entertainment. You already know, man. But, hey, we got Donald Trump's bitch ass, man. And I'm happy to say that he's finally impeached, man. Too much fuckery, bro. He's not, number one, he's not fit to be a president because he lacks political experience. Number two, he talks about how he's a businessman, this and that, this and that, how he's the best businessman ever, but he don't act like it, he don't talk like it. He's the only president that's actually been so obsessed with social media. And when I say only president, it's because some people say social media wasn't out when Bill Clinton was in office or when George Bush was in office. But social media was out when Obama was in office, and he was never constantly threatening people on Twitter, bullying people on Twitter, you know what I'm saying? And congratulations to that one 16-year-old girl who won that award. And Donald Trump, he was a straight hater. And let me tell you why he was a hater. He went straight on Twitter and started rambling about her. And I think that shows character about Donald Trump. It shows characteristics that he's a fucking bully. And that's the reason why world leaders don't acknowledge him as a leader in general. Because world leaders weren't constantly gossiping about Obama behind his back when he was in office. But for some reason, world leaders all over the world are gossiping about Trump and do not agree with the things that he agrees with, because Donald Trump has characteristics of a white supremacist, same person that called himself a nationalist. And there is no way you can change the definition of a nationalist, because a nationalist is definition for a white nationalist, from my knowledge. If I'm wrong, let me know, but from my knowledge, it's a white supremacist. And he just shows a lot of characteristics of white supremacists. And I just don't see how you could be a person of color and still go for Trump or agree with any of the things he says. I mean, number one, he wants to build a wall. How many of you guys think a wall is gonna stop Mexicans from entering this country? How many of y'all think that? Because a wall is just gonna be wasting thousands and thousands of our tax dollars. And for what? Because you wanna build a wall that's not even gonna keep immigrants out, because we build walls and then we don't build walls. We dig tunnels. We ride airplanes, you know what I'm saying? There's no way you can keep immigrants out this country no matter how hard you try, because the wall's not gonna stop a tunnel, and the wall damn sure ain't gonna stop a plane. So that's just what I have to say on that. And number two, I'm happy he got impeached, because if he's still in office and serves four more years, there's gonna be a lot more violence going on. There's gonna be a lot more nonsense going on in 2020, and I feel like 2020 is gonna be a year where it's gonna turn into a 1960 all over again, because Donald Trump and his supporters don't know how to. You still have people that grew up in the 60s and shit like that and actually seen segregation and seen all that, and they're still trying to influence that part of history. Not now, like right now. When another thing, Donald Trump, I feel like he is the reason for most mass shootings, because the one that shot up El Paso, I think he's the one that went to El Paso, shot up that Walmart. His Facebook background photo was Trump spelt out in guns, and all types of guns. And then I'm just thinking to myself, wow, it's a shame how these type of people are over here. It's a shame how Donald Trump only attracts these type of people. He don't attract positive minded people. He don't attract positive minded people. He does not attract good functioning minded people in general. If you do support him, clearly you don't. There's so much things that's going on. Like, he would say he would date his own daughter, and just for that, how can you support him? How can you say that's your president? You know what I'm saying? It's just a bunch of bullshit to me, honestly. But if I can say anything, one thing I can definitely say is Donald Trump is a criminal. He is not a leader. And if he serves another term, then I feel like it could be over for humanity itself, man. But hey, if I'm wrong, let me know, man, because I can debate my ass off and I do my research before I say anything. You know what I'm saying? And Donald Trump is segregating and dividing this country. And if you say he's bringing people together, you are a lie. He denied Puerto Rico a proper American aid. The only countries that he calls shithole countries are countries of leaders of color. Like, when was the last time you said France was a shithole country? Sweden a shithole country? When was the last time you said Canada was a shithole country? You know what I'm saying? I just can't believe it. But that's the video right there, guys. And if you're new here, like, subscribe. And if there's anything else y'all need me to react to, comment down below. And go hit up CDB Entertainment. Go hit up Mr. McIntyre and Cowboy, man. And go fuck with them for the merchandise and the new music, man, that's on the way. 2020 is already coming up. Merry motherfucking Christmas, guys. Have a happy new year. And catch you on the next episode.